That's the parable of the prodigal son. There's some parts about that that are pretty interesting. Back in the Jewish time, when there's two sons, the oldest son got most of the inheritance and the younger son only got one third of it. But to ask for your inheritance before your father died was basically saying, I want you dead. I no longer want to be in your life. I wish you were dead so I can have the inheritance that I would get. He was actually asking his father to die. And what was astonishing about this parable? The father says, okay, you can have your inheritance now before I'm dead. I'm giving it to you. And so the son goes off and squanders his money. But then he does come to his senses and say, I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. He repents and comes back. And you kind of think, well, what type of father would accept him back after the son says, I no longer want to be part of your life. I wish you were dead. But the father sees the son off in the distance and runs to greet him, welcomes him back with compassion. And he says, he's still my son. Get a robe, a ring for his finger, shoes. Let's have a feast. He's back. And the older son is pretty frustrated. He's been there with his father all along and always served him well. But here's this younger son who wished that his father was dead and goes away and spends the money, then comes crawling back. Why would you ever do something like that? You accept him back. It's kind of the contradictions in the parable itself and of the parable of that time when Jesus gave it, that would that really happen? Nowadays I'm thinking this parable would never happen, or would it? Actually, I have a friend, an affiliate that we had children and he got divorced. His children was living with mother. And he tried to keep in contact with his children. And his daughter said, I don't want to be part of your life anymore. I don't want to see you anymore. Initially, he was pretty upset. He was going, well, I can go to court and get an injunction, so she has to come and visit me every so often. And I can do all these things to make it happen. So he started to write a letter. Dear daughter, I let you go. I'll be here if you want me, but go. It's like he was dead to that daughter. A few months later, he got a phone call from someone who was going to go on a trip and just wanted some advice. What it would be like to go out to Seattle for a few days and visit with some friends. And he said, well, that'd be pretty neat because Seattle's a neat place. But you're going out there and you're going to go out and visit with some people from the opposite sex, and they may think it's kind of weird that you're coming out to visit with them. There could be some things to watch out for and hope the best for you. But consider that when you make your plans to go out there. He was then asked, who was on the phone? said, that was my daughter. She called me up. She made that step to make contact with the father. He was so overcome with that joy of making that connection again. So when God the Father welcomes you back, you go to confession, and you become connected with Him, He can really feel that. He has the joy of you coming back. I can relate to that because I'm that father. That was my daughter who called me. I'm now connected with my daughter again. The great joy in my heart to have my daughter back. I can also relate to the older son, because like most of you, I'm a cradle Catholic. I was born, baptized Catholic as a child. Went to Mass every Sunday. So I can understand where someone who goes off and does all sorts of things and wants to come back and say, wait a minute, I've been always here, God. Why are you so happy about that other person? I can also relate to the prodigal son, because I'm not perfect, just ask my wife, she'll tell you. But I keep coming back. A former spiritual director that I know had a saying that always come back one more time than you leave. Always come back one more time than you leave. So, I can understand the Father's joy of when you return to Him, as I've experienced it. I have a song that kind of conveys this feeling. God is waiting for you, and He's willing to pour out His mercy on you. You listen to this song. Yeah. I would rent a whole night on it. God wants to rent a whole you, Joe, and here's love for you.